Jan sir, Facebook is not all that bad. So I was actually following, I have been following A.P.J. Abdul Kalam on Facebook, and he quoted a very insightful example, a very insightful quote, and he says, he puts a question mark, how do we as educationists, teachers and parents make science taught in a way that it appeals the young mind? And this question mark really hits the right button. Okay, let's get started. Before I start, I must tell you that I don't take this opportunity to have any kind of preaching of sorts, but I'm just here to share my insight, my experience and my perspective as a teacher come trainer. Some of you might be knowing that I'm working as a teacher as well as a trainer, and I have been working for the last 5 years as a teacher come trainer, and teaching come training is not only my profession, it's actually my passion, and no doubts about it. Technically, I have been teaching since my high school days, and those were the times when we were actually going through some financial crisis, and I wanted to take the responsibility of my education through the earnings which I used to make by tutoring students junior to me, and I really don't know when and how it became a kind of passion to me, and once it became a passion, I really decided to make a full-fledged entry into this noble profession. Okay, so as Albert Einstein says, education is not the learning of facts, but the training of the mind to think. Okay, from a trainer's perspective, I'm really sorry to say, shall we talk pedagogy or andragogy? Andragogy was a very new term to me, and I was not knowing about it, what this term means. And when I started working as a trainer and started working with professionals, I really realized that sometimes I was making mistakes even while my teaching. Okay, so pedagogy versus andragogy. Andragogy would be new to us. I don't take credit for my feedback, but yes, of course, I would say that I just experimented. I just did things differently in a different manner, and I didn't follow pedagogy as a whole. And I really give credit to andragogy. Pedagogy is a Greek word which means cat means child, and gogy means how to lead. So pedagogy is actually the way we as together lead a child. Okay, andragogy is again a Greek word, and it has been originated from andra, means adult mind, mature people, youngsters, and gogy means again how to lead. So pedagogy, on one hand, pedagogy means how to lead a child, then andragogy means how to lead a young person, how to lead a youngster. And this is very interesting that children and adults and youngsters, their learning styles are very different. Because if pedagogy is sometimes control oriented, it is quite, you know, sometimes it becomes focused on control and fear, then andragogy is more participation oriented. And andragogy states that we learn best when we participate. When we participate, when we act, when we do something all together ourselves, then we learn best. Okay, next question. Now, a recent hate group research says we are dealing with an awkward generation of young professionals brought up on a time of texting and rote learning, and they are joining the workforce. And this is really surprising. This is really shocking. We are dealing with, on day-to-day basis, these days we are dealing with those young people equipped with gadgets, high gadgets, they are equipped with their smartphones, they are having a high dose of internet, they are having a high dose of media exposure, and sometimes we do feel that they know it all. They have a kind of attitude that they know it all, and they have very, very, you know, little patience, and we are dealing with them. And when we deal with them as if they are little kids, then of course that way of teaching them, that way of learning them doesn't make sense to them.